it's time for one of the most prestigious awards of the night, Sports Personalities Coach of the Year. Gary?
Thanks, Sue. To present the award for Coach of the Year, I'm delighted to welcome Britain's greatest ever Olympian, Sir Steve Redgrave. Thank you for joining us, Sir Steve. This year has been a fantastic year for British sport. England qualified for the World Cup with flying colours. In cricket, we won the Ashes. We have a British Formula One world champion. We have gold medalists in gymnastics, cycling and diving. We even had a British heavyweight boxing world champion. And this has all been due to one man. A man who often shies away from the spotlight. And many don't even know that he's behind most of our magnificent triumphs. But tonight, we pay tribute to our Coach of the Year, Smithy. Let's take a look at who he's been working with and what he's achieved this year.
Sorry? I'm gonna concentrate. Try to concentrate. Ridiculous. Every time, listen, watch. Come here, come here, come here. Get out.
Just think a few of the cuts recently haven't been up to standard, do you know what I mean?
I'm losing it a little bit there, so just...
No, you're not. No, it's lovely. Yeah. A bit here. There you go. I think this is going to look really nice.
I agree.
This could be one of our best ones. Oh, we've got some pinks here, David. We've forgotten about.
Oh. Pink. Pinks.
A couple of silly billies.
Well. Let's put some.
Yeah.
Actually, you have this one.
Mind you. You. Stop it, you silly billy. Get that one in.
Sweden kept on coming at us. Unlike our goal in the first half, you could see theirs was due. We just lost concentration. We had to beat Finland just to give us a chance. Germany and Munich was 5 months away.
Amazing together, those two.
I think we're amazing together, us two.
I agree. I love you, man.
I love you.
5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3. Clap. 1, 2, 3. On the right, Wayne. 1, 2, 3. That's it, Rio. On the left. 2, 3. And the arms. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Great session, freestyle. Yes, Rio. Yes. Yes.
Nothing's gonna ever keep you down. You're the best. I'm delighted and honoured to present the Coach of the Year to a real inspiration to me, Smithy.
This means the world to me. Firstly, I want to thank Fabio, Fablar. It's been a pleasure taking you under my wing, and you mean the world to me. Gianni Allore, lo inspirate, ti amo. I want to thank my mum and Rudy and Pamela and Mick and Gavlar, of course. Mostly, I want to thank my boy, Neil. Everything I do is to make you proud. And actually, I'm sorry. I can't accept this. What is this? This is all wrong. This isn't sport. This is showbiz. You lot sitting here in your dicky bows and your trendy frocks, you don't care about winning. You only care about awards and titles. I mean, Sir Steve Redgrave. Sir Steve, come on, mate. What do you need a knighthood for? You row around in a little boat. Me and my nephew did that at the weekend. I mean, Dame Kelly Holmes. Kelly, you got 2 gold medals, but essentially your job is just running around. Running around in circles. You don't need a damehood. You're not Judi Dench. I mean, there's a proper runner, right? Paula Radcliffe. You do 800 metres. She does 26 miles occasionally. You don't see her demanding titles and awards. There is a true sporting legend. And I tell you, it's great to see you, Paula. Are you being looked after? Have people showed you where the toilets and stuff are? Not that you need them, really. Go where you like, okay? Giggsy, great to see you, my man. Still hanging in there, still going strong. What are you now, 46, 47? It's going great. I tell you what, how you were never picked for England, I don't know, right? It's a disgrace. Freddie Flintoff. What's your real name? Andrew. Whatever. You know what, congratulations on the Ashes, you did brilliant. It was great to see you out there, but you're gonna give up now? You're gonna stop playing because your knee hurts? Is it sore? Is it a bit poorly, yeah? Bit of poorly knee? I tell you what, your arm's all right though, isn't it? In fact, your knee looked pretty good when you were shooting that deodorant commercial last year. Ba-bang, cha-ching, ba-bang, cha-ching. You are a disgrace. You never give up on your country. You let your country give up on you, all right? Talk to Steve McLaren, Graham Taylor. You're a joke. Pendleton. You is looking fine, gal. You know what? You got it. You've got it. I don't even know what it is, but you got it, yeah? And any time you just want to get together, hang out, talk about, I don't know, tyres or gears. Lance Armstrong, yeah? Just let me know, yeah? You got my digits, you hook me up, okay? Nice, good things. Amir Khan, you're at the top of your game. You are doing great, my son. Good for you. I tell you what I think you need. What I think you need right now, at this point in your career, is a catchphrase. I'm talking, you're not a mean Harry. You're not a mean Harry. Seriously, Frank, how many pantos you get off the back of that? 12? 13? Honestly, Amir, you play your cards right, you get a catchphrase, this time next year, you could be on Strictly. Yeah? Oh, and look who it is. Look who it is. Sebastian Coe. Seb Coe. Lord Coe. I bet you're pleased with yourself, ain't ya? It's all going well, yeah? You've got your Olympics, you've got your little 2012, it's all worked out, yeah? Feeling pleased with yourself, yeah? The traffic getting out of Essex is already a nightmare. Look at you. Sat there in your suit is lordship. I remember when you was just a runner mugging off Steve Ovett. Now you're just like the rest of this lot. All of you, you've lost your way. It's become muddled somehow. You've forgotten what's important. I don't see a room full of sporting legends here. I see a room full of people looking for their next sponsorship deal, book deal, TV series. You wouldn't see W.T. Grace demean himself on Ready, Steady, Cook. Roger Bannister wouldn't have had a Twitter page. Fred Perry, Bobby Moore, Duncan Goodhue, these are true sporting legends. You lot, you need to get back to basics. Remember who you are, what you are, what you stand for. Can we win the World Cup? Yes, we can. Can we win at Wimbledon? Yes, we can. Can we win at the Olympics? And I'm talking proper medals, not just swimming and cycling, ones that actually count, basically running. Yes, we can! Can we do this, people of Britain? Can we? Can we do this, Jensen Button?
Yes, we can!
Can we do this, David Hay?
Yes, we can!
Can we do this, Chris Akabusi?
Yes, we can! Yeah.
Don't believe in your agents. Don't believe in your managers. Don't believe in your publicists. Believe in yourselves, because we believe in you. And together, if we unite, we can make Britain great once more. Thank you.